tones right here. But it's more of a sort of a gag on when we started to, when we first got together, the whole scene sort of idea that we didn't want to be so serious in naming our band. It seemed kind of ridiculous that we had to organize things from just starting to play together for fun. That we wanted to make a joke both about rock, like Buffalo Springfield and things like that. And Bill is the singer of our band, so Buffalo Bill, someone said. And Tom's sort of shy, and we thought that would sort of make fun of him too, so we called it Buffalo Tom. So people would ask questions like this, and you'd get all red. In Germany, I think that's really important these days. People tell us that independent labels, bands, people make a big distinction. And it was like that in the United States, I think, in the early 80s, but at the end of the 80s, bands start, independent bands that we grew up with, started to sign major label things, you know, the Replacements, Husker Du, and now Sonic Youth and things. So there's less of that feeling in the United States. Although we are on a label that has major label distribution in the United States, we still like the idea of the independent buyer and sort of being able to put out music that we like, and then we get to choose the album covers and things like that.